Please turn with me in your Bibles to Matthew chapter 4, and we will read verses 1 through 11.
请打开你的圣经到马太福音四章十一节，四章一到十一节。
Give attention to the reading of God's holy word. Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And after fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. And the tempter came and said to him, If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread. But he answered, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Then the devil took him to the holy city and set him on the pinnacle of the temple and said to him, If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, He will command his angels concerning you.And on their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. Jesus said to him, Again, it is written, You shall not put the Lord your God to the test. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, All these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said to him, Be gone, Satan.For it is written, You shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and were ministering to him. Thus far the reading of God's word.
马太福音第四章第一节到第十一节。当时耶稣被圣灵引导到旷野，受魔鬼的试探。他禁食四十昼夜，后来就饿了。那试探的人进前来对他说你若是神的儿子可以吩咐这些石头变成食物耶稣却回答说经上记着说人活着不是单靠食物乃是靠神口里出的一切话魔鬼就带他进入了圣城叫他站在殿顶上对他说你若是神的儿子可以跳下去因为经上记着说主要为你吩咐他的使者用手托着你免得你的脚碰在石头上耶稣对他说经上又记着说不可试探你主你的神魔鬼又带他上了一座最高的山将世上的万国与万国的荣华都指给他看对他说你若俯伏拜我我就把这一切都赐给你耶稣说撒旦退去吧因为经上记着说当拜主你的神单单要侍奉他于是魔鬼离开了耶稣有天使来伺候他
Our text this morning is the account of the temptation of Jesus by the devil
我们今天早上的经文是记述了耶稣接受魔鬼的试探
But before we dive in we need to recall the baptism of Jesus in the previous chapter Matthew 3 which sets the stageFor the temptation of Jesus in Matthew chapter 4.
当我们进入这段经文前，我们先回忆一下马太福音第三章耶稣受洗的这段，同时也在为这一章也同时也在为第四章中耶稣受试探来铺陈了舞台。
The testing of Jesus is the sequel to the baptism of Jesus.
所以耶稣受试探的这一段呢？是耶稣受洗后的一个续集。
At the baptism of Jesus, the voice of God the Father from heaven said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased."
当耶稣受洗后，圣父上帝的声音从天上降下来说，这是我的爱子，我所喜悦的。
Likewise, in the testing of Jesus, the devil takes up the words of God the Father, and he says,If you are the Son of God.
在耶稣受试探的时候，魔鬼使用了这段话说，如果你是上帝的儿子，就。
The baptism of Jesus is the manifestation of his identity as the Son of God.
基督受洗是在彰显他作为上帝儿子的身份。
The testing of Jesus is the exploration of what his identity as the Son of God means.
而基督受试探是为了发掘作为上帝的儿子这个身份的意义。
Does it mean that he can use his divine prerogatives for his own advantage?
这是否意味着他可以使用他作为神的一个特权？
Or does it mean that he must be obedient to his father in spite of the cost to himself?
或者意味着他必须顺服神，尽管付出他自己作为代价？
Now, in addition to this connection of the identity of Christ as the Son of God being explored in both the baptism and the testing of Jesus, there's another thing that connects the two narratives, and that is the Spirit, the Holy Spirit.
此外，耶稣的洗礼与受试探都是为了解释作为上帝儿子的这个身份。另外还有一件事，那就是圣灵将两件事情连在一起。
Recall, at the baptism of Jesus, the Spirit came down upon him in the form of a dove, anointing him as the Messiah.
当耶稣受洗的时候，圣灵如同鸽子临到并膏抹他，作为弥赛亚。
In our text, the temptation of Jesus, we read, Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness.
在经文里说，圣灵带领他到旷野，接受魔鬼的试探。
The Spirit's leading Jesus into the wilderness to be tempted is connected with his identity as the Son of God.
圣灵带领耶稣进入旷野，受魔鬼的试探，正是将耶稣作为上帝的儿子的身份连接起来。
The Spirit came upon Jesus at his baptism, anointing him and marking him out as the Son of God.
而这位膏抹耶稣作为神的儿子的印记的圣灵，同时也是带领他到旷野的圣灵。
And the same Spirit then anointed him has now led him into the wilderness.
这是同一个圣灵带领他到旷野去。
Jesus then resists the devil's temptations to misuse his divine power as God's son for selfish ends.
那耶稣拒绝了魔鬼，要耶稣滥用作为神的儿子的能力来满足私欲的试探。
Instead, he obediently submits to the Father's will and endures suffering.
同时也顺服了上帝的旨意，在苦难中忍耐着。
And by doing this, Jesus not only defeats the devil, but he shows that he really is the obedient Son of God, perfectly pleasing to God, just as God had declared from heaven.
如此这样的行，耶稣不仅击败了魔鬼，并证明了他是那位顺服上帝的儿子。
I have three points for my sermon today.
今天我有三点在我的讲道中。
First, Jesus is being tested by God as his incarnate son.
第一点，耶稣正受到作为降生的圣子来被考验。
Second, Jesus is being tested as the true Israel.
第二点，耶稣将被作为真以色列来被考验。
And third, he is being tested as a foreshadow of the end, that is the cross.
第三点，耶稣正为末后，他事工末后，也就是上十字架的这件事情来被考验。
So first, Jesus is being tested by God as His incarnate Son.
第一点，耶稣被作为降生的圣子来受考验。
Now, at first, you might think that it's the devil who is testing Jesus.
正如各位所想到的，我们所看到是魔鬼在试探耶稣。
After all, that is what the text explicitly says.
这毕竟是经文里面所讲的。
But while it is certainly true, it is a surface reading.
即使这是事实，但是这也是表面上字义。
Ultimately, it is God who is testing His Son Jesus.
这个事实终究是上帝在引导。
The fact that ultimately it is God who is testing Jesus can be seen from the fact that the Spirit led Jesus into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil.
是圣灵引导耶稣进入旷野，受魔鬼的试探。
In the Gospel of Mark, it is worded even more strongly. It says that the Spirit drove Jesus.Into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil.
在马可福音里面使用的字眼更强烈，是圣灵驱使耶稣到旷野接受魔鬼的试探。
God is ultimately in control of the devil's temptation.
上帝终究在掌权中，即使当下是魔鬼在试探耶稣。
What we're witnessing in this account isn't just the devil trying to tempt Jesus.
在这记述当中，我们所见证的并不只是魔鬼在试探耶稣。
We're witnessing God using the temptation of the devil in order to test Jesus.
我们同时也见证了上帝正在使用魔鬼来试探耶稣，来魔鬼的试探来考验耶稣。
This can be seen even in the Greek word that is used. This word has two meanings.
即使在希腊语中也看得出来，试探这个字有两个意思。
One meaning is tempt.
第一个意思是试探，
which is used twice in our text in verse 1 and verse 3, where it says to be tempted by the devil or the tempter.
这个字用了两次，在马太福音四章一节跟三节，魔鬼的试探，还有就是那试探者前来。
Clearly, in these two verses, the word has a negative meaning to entice someone to sin.
所以很清楚的，这两个例子是一个负面的含义。
But this same word can also be used in a neutral sense, meaning to test.
但这个字也可以用在一个中性的含义上，也就是去测试。
Both meanings are possible.
两个意思都有可能。
From Satan's point of view, he's trying to entice Jesus to sin, to turn away from his messianic mission.
也就是说，从撒旦的角度来看，他是试着去引诱耶稣犯罪，并离开他弥赛亚事工的这个职分。
But from God's point of view, he is using the temptation of Satan as a test in the full confidence that his son will pass the test and come out victorious.
但从上帝的角度看，上帝是用撒旦的试探来试验他的儿子，并充满了信心，相信着他的儿子将会迎来胜利。
This is important because if we think it is only the devil tempting Jesus and not God using the devil to test Jesus, then we'll miss that the fundamental thing happening here is that Jesus isn't just being tempted. He is being tested by God to see if he is God's obedient son.
这个概念非常的重要，因为假如我们只相信只有魔鬼在试探耶稣，而没有看到上帝正在使用魔鬼的试探来考验耶稣，我们将遗漏掉了一个基本的概念。那概念就是，耶稣不只是被试探，他被作为是否是那位顺服的儿子来被上帝考验。
Now we have to admit that there's something a little bit odd about speaking of Jesus as being tested by God.Isn't Jesus God?
Okay, so now we have to admit, when we say Jesus is being tested, it sounds a little strange. Because Jesus is not God?
Well, yes, he is. But it's more accurate to say that he is God's son who has taken on human nature.
Yes, he is God. But to say it more correctly,他是上帝的儿子，取了人的样式。
The narrative way back in Matthew chapter 1 about the virgin birth of Jesus makes this clear.
在马太福音第一章记载着童贞女怀孕这件事，很清楚地说出这样的概念。
He is Emmanuel, God with us.
他是以马内利，上帝与我们同在。
He is the Son of God incarnate.
他是上帝的儿子降生。
And so when we say he's being tested by God, what we mean is that God the Father is testing his incarnate son.
所以当我们说他是被上帝考验，我们指的是父神上帝正在考验他降生的儿子。
Jesus is both God and man in two natures and one person.
耶稣是神人二性在一个位格中。
God the Father is testing his Son, but not the divine nature of the Son.
上帝所测试的不是耶稣的神性，而是将他的儿子作为一个真正的人、无罪的人、降生的儿子来考验。
Rather, he is testing the Son as a true and sinless man, as the incarnate Son.
而是将他的儿子作为一个没有罪的人来考验。
Second, Jesus is being tested as the true Israel.
第二点，耶稣被作为真以色列来被考验。
The idea that Jesus is the true Israel is made clear in Matthew chapter 3.
在马太福音三章中明确地点出耶稣是真以色列的这个想法。
In Matthew chapter 3, Jesus identified with the people in their sin and repentance.
在这里耶稣做耶稣在那里走进罪人当中与他们同在。
Remember, John was baptizing sinners with a baptism of repentance.
请记得约翰向罪人施悔改的洗。
And the fact that Jesus came to be baptized by John was puzzling at first.
所以耶稣要去让约翰来受受约翰的洗，这是令人感到困惑的。
But remember what Jesus said.
但记得耶稣曾说。
He said to John the Baptist, "Permit it to be so now, in order to fulfill all righteousness."
耶稣说，你暂且许我，因为我们理当尽诸般的义。
Jesus had to identify with his people in order to represent them and to fulfill the righteousness that God expected from his people Israel.
所以耶稣必须要跟他的子民一样，以能代表他们，并实现上帝对以色列所期望的公义。
At his baptism, Jesus stepped into the shoes of Israel, and from now on, he must be the obedient and righteous man where Israel had failed.
所以在洗礼中，耶稣走进了以色列，而从那刻开始，他必须顺服，并行使以色列所无法行使的义。
Jesus is corporate Israel narrowed down to an individual.
耶稣代表整个以色列群体至个人。
Saying that Jesus is the true Israel is another way of saying that he is God's obedient son.
所以我们说耶稣是真以色列，就是换句话说，他就是那位顺服上帝的儿子。
Now, in Matthew chapter 4, that idea is continued and fleshed out further.
这个概念在第四章中有更进一步的阐明。
There are three things in our text that point to the Israel identity of Jesus.
有三件事指出耶稣是真以色列的这个身份。
First, just as Israel crossed through the water, that is the Red Sea, and then went into the wilderness to be tested, so Jesus crossed through the water of baptism at the Jordan River, and then went into the wilderness to be tested.
所以第一件事情就是以色列渡过红海，进入旷野受试炼。一样的，耶稣走入了约旦河，并进入旷野接受试炼。
Second, just as Israel spent 40 years in the wilderness, so Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights.
第二件事情就是犹如以色列人花了40年的时间在旷野，相同的耶稣也花了40天昼夜在旷野。
Third, just as Israel in the wilderness experienced hunger and thirst and various tests in which they learned to trust God to provide, so Jesus experienced hunger and thirst and learned to trust God.
第三件事情如同以色列人一样在旷野中经历的饥饿口渴，还有不同的试炼，耶稣也经历的饥饿口渴，但是他在饥饿口渴中信靠上帝。
God is testing Jesus just as he tested Israel in the wilderness.
上帝考验基督，如同他考验以色列人进入旷野。
Listen to these words from Deuteronomy chapter 8, where God, speaking through Moses to the nation Israel, is speaking to them in the wilderness as they're on the verge of entering into the promised land.
上帝考验基督，如同他考验以色列人进入旷野。生命记第八章一到三节这一段记载着，上帝借着摩西在旷野的边缘准备进入应许之地，对以色列人说的。
Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 1 to 3. The whole commandment that I command you today, you shall be careful to do. This is Moses speaking. That you may live and multiply and go in and possess the land that the Lord swore to give to your fathers. And you shall remember the whole way that the Lord your God has led you these 40 years in the wilderness, that he might humble you, testing you to see what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. And he humbled you and let you hunger and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man does not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord.
生命记第八章一到三节说，我今日所吩咐你的一切诫命，你们要谨守遵行，好叫你们存活，人数增多，并且进去得耶和华向你们列祖启示应许的那地。你也要纪念耶和华你的神在旷野引导你这四十年，要苦练你，试验你，要知道你的内心如何，肯守他的诫命不肯。他苦练你，任你饥饿，将你和列祖所不认识的玛纳赐给你吃，使你知道人活着不是单靠食物，乃是靠耶和华口里所出的一切话。
In the same way, the Spirit led Jesus into the wilderness to be subjected to the temptations of the devil in order to know what was in Jesus' heart, whether he would keep his Father's commandments or not.
相同的，圣灵借着带领耶稣进入旷野，面对魔鬼的试探，去了解耶稣的内心是否遵行父神的命令。在面对魔鬼的试探，耶稣 go ahead.
And in response to the devil's tests, Jesus quotes three times from this passage in Deuteronomy. Twice from Deuteronomy chapter 8, once from Deuteronomy chapter 8, and twice from chapter 6.
而在面对魔鬼的试探，耶稣引用了三次律法中的话，也就是我们刚刚朗读过的《生命记》八章三节，从耶稣引用了上帝的律法，可以看出耶稣就是。
By quoting from the book of the law of God, it is clear that Jesus is taking up Israel's role and keeping the law where Israel failed.
从引用了上帝的律法，可以看出耶稣成就了以色列的这个角色，并且遵行了以色列所无法遵行的律法。
Jesus is being tested as the true Israel.
耶稣作为真以色列被考验。
So how does Jesus, as the true Israel, pass the test?
耶稣是如何通过这些考验的？
Let's go through each of the three tests and see. The first test.
让我们来看看以下的三样考验。
Verse 3. The tempter came and said to Jesus, If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread.
在第三节，那试探的人前来对他说，你若是神的儿子，可以吩咐这些石头变成食物。
In other words, the devil is saying, You don't have to put up with this, Jesus. You are the Son of God. You don't deserve to be starved to death out here in the desert. Satisfy your hunger by turning these stones into bread.
换句话来说，魔鬼想要说的是，你可以不必去忍受这一切，因为你是上帝的儿子。你不需要去忍受饥饿，甚至死在旷野中。 来吧，去满足你的需求，将石头变为饼吧。
But Jesus answers the devil by quoting Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 3. It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
但耶稣引用了《生命记》八章三节说，人活着不是单靠食物，乃是靠耶和华口里所出的一切话。
And in the context,Every word that comes from the mouth of God is what? It's the commandments that God gave to Israel.
这经文的含义是，任何从上帝口中所出的话就是命令，是上帝颁给以色列人的命令。
Jesus refuses to use his divine power to satisfy himself, and instead he continues to obediently suffer the test of being hungry that God has placed before him.
耶稣拒绝使用神性的力量去满足他自己，并在顺服上帝所赐给他的饥饿与困苦当中。
He keeps the commandments of God.
他遵行了上帝的命令。
He stays within his appointed role as the true Israel who must obey God.
他持守了上帝，他所领受的职分，作为一个。顺服上帝的人。
And so he obeyed God and did not try to get out of this situation, even though he is in tremendous pain.
他遵行上帝，即使他是在他顺服上帝，即使他是在一个非常痛苦的状况。
The second test is in verses 5 and 6. Then the devil took him to the holy city.And set him on the pinnacle of the temple, and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, He will command His angels concerning you, and on their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone."
第二个考验是记载在第五到六节，魔鬼就带他进了圣城，叫他站在圣殿的顶上，对他说。你若是上帝的儿子，可以跳下去，因为经上记着说，主要为你吩咐他的使者用手托着你，免得你的脚碰到石头上。
In this second test, the devil is trying to entice Jesus to get out of this difficult trial by suggesting that he jump to safety.
在第二个试验中，魔鬼要诱导耶稣，脱离试炼并跳入安逸中。
Jesus could simply escape the stress and the difficulty of this test by simply jumping to safety from the devil's grasp.
耶稣大可借着魔鬼的建议跳入安逸中来逃出这个试炼所带来的压力。
The devil's argument is plausible. It's okay to jump from this high point of the temple.Jumping would be a great way out of the situation. Surely God will send an angel to catch you.
魔鬼的论点听起来是合理的。从圣殿的高处往下跳当然是没有问题的。往下跳绝对是一个好的方法来逃离现在这个处境。当然上帝也一定会差遣他的天使来接住你。
But Jesus refuses to jump to safety and continues to obediently endure the suffering in the wilderness that God has appointed for him.
但耶稣拒绝跳脱来寻求安逸，反而是继续顺服上帝所赐给他的试炼当中。
We read in verse 7 that Jesus said to him, Again, it is written, You shall not put the Lord your God to the test.
这经文的第七节中描述，耶稣对他说，经上有记载，记着说，不可试探你的神。
Here Jesus is quoting from Deuteronomy 6, verse 16.
这里耶稣所引用的经文是《生命记》第六章第十六节的话。
This is a reference to the time when Israel, tested the Lord at Massa and Meribah.
这段话是引用在以色列人出埃及记当中，是在马萨和米利巴，接受试炼的情况。
The story is recorded for us in Exodus 17, right after God's great deliverance when they had crossed the Red Sea.
这故事是记载在出埃及记第十七章，在上帝伟大的拯救之后，以色列人跨过红海。
The people were up in arms because there was no water in the wilderness.
人们开始争吵，因为没有水。
They demanded that Moses give them water to drink.
他们要求摩西给他们水喝。
And they cried out, "Why did you bring us out of Egypt? Did you bring us out of Egypt just to kill us with thirst?"
他们向摩西发怨言说，你为什么将我们从埃及领出来，使我们和我们的儿女并牲畜都饿死。
They were showing their unbelief.
在这里他们显出他们的不信。
They were testing God, in effect questioning whether God was really among them or not.
他们在这里试探上帝，并质疑上帝是否与他们同在。
Jesus is just like Israel. He has come up out of the waters of baptism and has been sent into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil with hunger and thirst.
耶稣就如同以色列从一样从受洗的水中走出来，并且被带到旷野中忍受饥饿的试炼。
But instead of complaining against God and doubting God and testing God as Israel did,Jesus accepts this trial from God without grumbling and without trying to find an easy way out.
但是他并没有像以色列人一样的抱怨，违背上帝，质疑上帝的试炼。
He is God's obedient son, the true Israel, and he passes the test by obediently submitting to the Father's will.
他是上帝顺服的儿子，借着顺服。
He passes the test by obediently submitting to God's will.
借着顺服而通过了这试炼。
Now, in the first two tests, the devil begins his temptation by saying, "If you are the Son of God."
在前面两个测试当中，魔鬼都说，如果你是上帝的儿子。
Ironically, if Jesus were to attempt to get out of the suffering that God has called him to endure, he would demonstrate that he wasn't God's obedient son. Ironically, if Jesus were to attempt to get out of the suffering that God had called him to endure, he would demonstrate that he wasn't God's obedient son.
如果耶稣离开了这个测试，他就没有办法证明他是上帝的儿子。
Jesus demonstrates his true identity as God's son precisely by not listening to the devil's suggestion that if he really is God's son, then he would easily be able to escape suffering.
耶稣作为 ，I'm sorry.
That's fine. We'll just move on to the next point.
Sorry.
We come now to the third test.
我们来到第三个考验。
Here it is a little different.
这里有一些不同。
Unlike the first two tests, this time the devil does not begin his temptation by saying, "If you are the Son of God."
不像前面的两个考验，魔鬼没有像前面试探耶稣的时候说，如果你是上帝的儿子。
Instead, he's more direct and tries to get Jesus to break the first commandment, requiring the exclusive worship of God alone.
他更直接地要求耶稣违背第一条诫命，也就是单单敬拜主你的神。
This is the highest commandment of the law, to love the Lord your God with all your heart.
这是最大的诫命，你要尽心尽力尽心爱主你的神。
The devil tries to get Jesus to commit the unthinkable sin, open and blatant rebellion against his father.
魔鬼试着要让耶稣去干犯那个不可想象的，干犯那个，那条诫命，犯那不可想象的罪，也就是违背他的父神。
Look at our text in verse 8. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, "All these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me."
在经文第八、第九节说，魔鬼带他到一座最高的山上，将世界的万国的荣华都给他看，对他说，你俯伏敬拜我，我就把这一切给你。
The devil wants Jesus to take a detour from the cross as the way to receiving the reward.
魔鬼要耶稣从这个作为这个弥赛亚的这个事工上改道。
But the price is high.
但这代价极为的高昂。
He must change allegiance from God to the devil.Just as Adam did in the garden.
他必须要改变他忠诚的对象，从上帝到魔鬼，就像当时的亚当一样。
Instead, Jesus refuses the devil's offer.
然而，耶稣拒绝了魔鬼的邀请。
Rather than being disloyal to his father and switching his allegiance to the devil,He continues to obediently honor his father alone.
耶稣选择继续顺服，并荣耀父神。
Just as the serpent tempted Adam in the garden, so he comes to tempt Jesus and to sidetrack him from obediently walking the path the Father has ordained for him, the path of the cross.Which is the only way to glory.
正如古蛇来试探亚当，魔鬼来诱惑耶稣。
Jesus responds, "Be gone, Satan! For it is written, 'You shall worship the Lord your God, and Him only shall you serve.'"
但耶稣回答撒旦，退去吧。因为经上记着说，当拜主你的神，单单要侍奉他。
Jesus here quotes from Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 13, a few verses after the Shema, the great confession of Judaism.
耶稣所引用的是《生命记》第六章第十三节，在 Shema 就是听啊之后，犹太教最大的诫命。
The Shema is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might.
以色列啊，你要听，耶和华我们的神是独一的主。你要尽心、尽性、尽力爱耶和华你的神。
The essence of God's law is that one must worship God and love God alone and not go after other gods.
上帝的律法的本质是要单单的只爱上帝，不去追求其他的神。
Of course, we know that the whole story of Israel is that they failed at this exact point.
当然，以色列人的历史在这里告诉我们，他们在这方面是完全失败的。
Again and again, the Israelites departed from exclusive loyalty to the one true God and worshipped other gods.
一次再一次的，以色列人远离了单一对上帝的忠诚，并寻找他们想的偶像。
Once again, we see Jesus presented here as the one true obedient Israelite.
在这里，我们从耶稣的身上看到，只有作为一个真以色列人的顺服。
Jesus has stepped into Israel's shoes, and the whole history of Israel has come to a climax in Jesus.
让耶稣已经踏进了踏进了以色列当中，这是一个高潮。
By refusing Satan's temptation to bow down and worship him, Jesus, in contrast with Israel, maintains covenant loyalty to God his Father, and in this way,He fulfills all righteousness.
透过拒绝了魔鬼的诱惑，耶稣与以色列人成了鲜明的对比。也在这里，他维持了圣约里的忠诚，并尽了诸般的义。
The third point of my sermon is this: Jesus is being tested as a foreshadow of the end.
第三点是耶稣被耶稣作为预示了他幕后的侍奉而被试探。
The temptation of Jesus here in Matthew chapter 4 is a foreshadow of the end of the gospel story, the sufferings, death, and resurrection of the Messiah.
在马太福音第四章这里的记述，耶稣接受了试探，是预示了他在弥赛亚里的受难。
This threefold test is a foreshadow of the final test that Jesus will face at the end, when he must go obediently to Jerusalem and allow himself to be arrested and crucified.
这三者的试探是预示了耶稣将要面对最后的试炼，也就是当他必须要顺服地走入耶路撒冷，被逮捕，被钉十字架。
Jesus' response to the devil's third temptation is very telling. He doesn't just respond in a passive way.
耶稣对魔鬼的回应，他并没有被动的回应，相反的，他是主动的出击。
Instead, he goes on the offense. Be gone, Satan.
他主动的说出撒旦退去吧。
This reminds us of the words of Jesus to Peter later in Matthew chapter 16.
这句话让我们想到在马太福音16章中，耶稣对彼得也说过同样的一句话。
We read, from that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and chief priests and scribes and be killed.And on the third day be raised. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, Far be it from you, Lord, this shall never happen to you. But Jesus turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me, for you are not setting your mind on the things of God, but on the things of man.
耶稣带着他们徒在马太福音第十六章中，耶稣对彼得说过同样一句话，就是耶稣带着他们徒上耶路撒冷去，被文士长老和并要在文士长老和祭司长中受许多的苦，被杀。第三日复活，那彼得拉着劝他说：“主啊，万不可如此，这必不临到你的身上。”耶稣转过来对他说：“撒旦，退后到我身边去吧，因为你不体贴神的意思，只体贴人的意思。”
The fact that Jesus uses the very same words here in the testing in the wilderness, get behind me, Satan, is a foreshadow of the cross.
这段事实是耶稣使用同样的一句话来面对旷野的试探，也就说明了耶稣所受的试探，同时也预告了十字架。
It is there at the cross that his conflict with the devil will come to a climax.And he will defeat the devil by obediently going to the cross to save his people.
而这也是他与魔鬼的对抗的一个对抗的这个情节进入了一个高潮，并自愿上十字架来拯救他的百以上十字架来拯救他的百姓的方式来击败魔鬼。
Recall in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus had to pass the test.And willingly submit to his Father's will, accepting the cup that the Father had given him to drink.
在客西马尼园里，耶稣必须通过这项试探，并愿意顺服在父神的旨意下，接受神所赐给他喝的这个杯。
Let's now conclude the sermon with the application.
我们来总结一下，并应用，看看这个经文的应用。
What a wonderful Savior we have.
我们有一个多么伟大的救主。
He is divine, the eternal divine Son of God.
他是神，是在永恒中的圣子上帝。
But he is not merely divine.
他不仅仅是神。
He isn't distant from us, saving us from a distance by his sheer power.
他并没有离我们很远，并在远距离用纯粹的所谓神的力量来拯救我们。
He is the divine Son of God who became a true and perfect man for us.
他是圣子上帝为我们成为真正与完美的人。
He is God's incarnate Son who takes up the place of Israel under the law.
他是神降生的儿子。
He entered into our world and into our lives. He is one of us and yet greater than us.
他进入了我们的世界，我们的生活中，住在我们当中。
The author of Hebrews describes our Savior in Hebrews chapter 2, verses 14 and following with these words of encouragement. Since therefore the children share in flesh and blood, he himself likewise partook of the same things, that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is the devil, and deliver all those who through fear of death were subject to lifelong slavery. For surely it is not angels that he helps, but he helps the offspring of Abraham. Therefore, he had to be made like his brothers in every respect, so that he might become a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God to make propitiation for the sins of the people.For because he himself has suffered when tempted, he is able to help those who are being tempted. We do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who in every respect has been tempted as we are, yet without sin.
希伯来书二章十四到十八节，四章十五节中提到，神儿女既同有血肉之体，他也照样亲自成为了血肉的肢体，特要借着死败坏那掌权的，也就是魔鬼，并要释放那些一生因怕死而成为奴仆的人。他并不救拔天使，乃救拔亚伯拉罕的后裔。所以他凡事该与他的弟兄相同，为要在神的事上成为慈悲忠信的大祭司，为百姓的罪献上挽回祭。他自己既然被试探而受苦，就能搭救被试探的人。四章十五节，因为我们的大祭司并非不能体恤我们的软弱，他也曾凡事受过试探，与我们一样，只是他没有犯罪。
Adam failed the test.
亚当在试探中失败了。
Israel in the wilderness failed the test.
以色列人在旷野中也遭受试炼，也失败了。
The kings of Israel and Judah failed the test.
犹大的王也在试炼中失败了。
You and I, we constantly fail the tests in our lives.
我们经常在许多的试探中失败了。
Yet Christ has succeeded where everyone else has failed.
但基督胜过了许多的试探。
He persevered in perfect obedience to the will of his Father, swatting away all the devil's lies and deceptions and all the temptations to deviate from God's will.
在完美的顺服父神的旨意下，他甩开了魔鬼的谎言与欺骗，和偏离上帝的旨意和自己的私欲。
And because Christ has done that, he is able to save us to the uttermost.
因为他完成了这些的试炼，他就能够拯救我们。
We can look to him for strength in our struggles and temptations.
我们可以在挣扎与试探当中仰望他来得到力量。
We do not look to Jesus merely as an example, but as a Savior.
我们不仅仅看耶稣只是一个救主，是一个榜样，而是救主。
For he has obeyed in our place.
他在我们的世界当中，他顺服了上帝。
And yet, his obedience is also something that he is working in us by his Spirit.
而他的顺服也借着圣灵在我们心中的工作。
He not only gives us a new record by clearing away the guilt of our sins, but a new heart.
我们不仅仅是得到一个新的，新的记录。而是一个新的心。
A heart that desires to honor God and to make him first in our lives.
一个饥渴慕义的心，一个想要荣耀上帝的心。
We are united to Christ, and thus we share in his sufferings and his glory, his conflict with the devil and his victory over the devil.
当我们与基督联合，我们也分享了他的苦难和荣耀，与魔鬼的对抗和得胜。
When Jesus taught his disciples to pray, he said that we should pray, "Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one."
当他在教导他的门徒祷告的时候，他说：“叫我们不要遇见试探，而救我们脱离凶恶。”
We can learn three principles from this text for guidance when we are tempted.
我们可以当考验来临时，我们可以在这经文当中学习到。
First, we must cling to the Word of God.
第一点，我们必须保守我们在自己在上帝的话语中。
As Jesus said, quoting from the Old Testament, "Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God."
人活着不是光靠着饼，而是上帝的话语。
Second, we must be aware of Satan's tricks.
我们必须对魔鬼的诡计有所警觉。
Notice how tricky Satan is. He even quotes scripture to Jesus to make his argument sound plausible and reasonable.
从撒旦引用经文对耶稣提出的论点看来是非常合理的。
Satan.
他也是在扭曲经文里的话。
Satan is twisting the scriptures, taking it out of context and misusing it to contradict what God has clearly revealed.
撒旦断章取义的扭曲圣经里的教导。
And third, we must see every temptation to sin as a temptation to deviate from the worship of God.
第三点，我们必须看待试探如同扭曲对上帝敬拜的罪恶。
We are called to glorify God in all that we do.
我们所要做的每件事上，我们必须先考虑上帝的荣耀。
Sin is fundamentally treason, disloyalty to God, seeking our own will and our own desires over God's will and God's glory.
罪恶的本质是对神的背叛、不忠诚。并将自己的欲望摆在上帝的荣耀之上。
The entire goal of Satan is to try to get us to deviate from the true worship of God.
而撒旦的目的就是要我们从真实的敬拜中走偏。
That's what he tried to get Adam and Israel to do.
那就是他对亚当和以色列人都做过的同样事情。
That's what idolatry is.
这就是偶像的敬拜。
And this fits in with the theocentric focus of the teaching of Jesus.
基督教导我们要以神为中心。
He'll bring it up again in the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 6. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
这个部分将会在登山宝训中与大家分享，先求他的国和他的义。
We cannot do battle with the devil in our own resources.
我们无法靠着自己与魔鬼对抗。
We cannot handle temptation merely by our own power.
我更无法纯粹透过自己的力量 来应对诱惑。
But thank the Lord that the battle has been won by Jesus Christ as the second Adam and the true Israel.
但感谢主，基督作为第二个亚当已经得胜。
He alone has the power to refute Satan and to tell him to be gone.
他有足够的力量去反驳撒旦，并且赶走他。
We are too weak, too easily distracted by sin and our selfish desires.
我们太过于软弱，也太容易被罪和我们的私欲所困。
Yet the victory of Christ over Satan is ours.
但基督的得胜也是我们的得胜。
Let us walk in that victory, not only by laying hold of Christ for forgiveness, but also for strength to submit to God's will, even when it is hard.
让我们在得胜中行走，不只单单靠着基督得到赦免，也靠着顺服在上帝的旨意中得着力量。
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father, how we thank you for giving us Jesus, your beloved Son.
父神，我们感谢你赐下耶稣，你的爱子。
Thank you that when he was tested, he did not seek to escape, but submitted himself to your will.
谢谢你，当他面对试探时，并没有逃离，而是顺服在父神你的旨意下。
Thank you that he is the true and obedient Israelite who has loved you with his whole heart.
主，我们感谢你，因为他是那位真实顺服的以色列人，是你所爱的。
Cause us to hide ourselves in him, so that when we are tempted, we may stand firm against the devil, not in our own strength, but in the power of Christ.
当我们面对试探时，我们可以在他里面成为刚强，来对抗魔鬼。这不是依靠我们自己的力量，而是依靠耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' name, Amen.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告，阿门。